It's milking time. So I got some Dixie cups. One's going to be to strip her, and then the other one I'm just going to take some of the udder wash and use that as a dip at the end. Put those aside. And I have Asriel's food here. It's already measured out. I put Evie's in her bucket. We're going to give this to Asriel while we're milking Evie so she gets a little bit to eat before Evie comes back. I use warm water on her. Well, this is a solution from Fiasco Farms. It's bleach and Dawn and warm water. Milk her into the small jar and I'll dump it into the big one.
You're like a pro with that.
I have Rose over at Wholesome Roots to thank for teaching me how to milk. I've watched a lot of milking videos, but hers was the absolute best one. So I was able to pick it up right away. Based on that video. I'm gonna dump in here. Sometimes Evie gets a little confused and thinks she's done milking at this point, and she'll sometimes sidestep. And it's usually a battle to get the rest of the milk, but we'll see how she does today.
Thank you.
see if she lets me sit next to her sometimes.
Seems like her having horns helps keep her in the head gate too.
She's done, but I'm not. I should try and get her head through that hole. She's really full today.
She filled up quick yesterday. Gotta feel better.
I gotta dump again.
You have another.
She's full. This is the most milk she's ever given.
Rubber butt.
Dip on her, and she doesn't like this. Alright, now her. I put her her minerals in her feed. We're gonna try something new today. This is Rescue Remedy by Bach. I'm never giving it to a goat. This is what I use. We're gonna see it for stress. We're gonna see if that works. I don't know. I don't know if you guys can hear, but we have the classical music station going in the background. Some of you guys recommended a radio. We figured it can't hurt. We'll give it a try. This is a natural fly spray that I made. It's made with Dr. Bronner's Castile soap, peppermint Castile soap, and lavender oil, essential oil, and a little bit of alcohol, and some water. And we're going to spray her down, help with flies, and also hopefully the lavender will calm her. And now we're going to go inside and we'll strain our milk and put it in the freezer. All right, these are the filters that I use. Kenag 6.5 inch. I have a clean mason jar with a stainless steel funnel and a stainless steel strainer. And we just strain it. I don't measure anything right now. Our goats are not registered, and I'm not doing any kind of milk tests, and I'm not too concerned about having to prove how much milk they produce, so I'm not weighing it at this point.
Why are you filtering?
No, we're just filtering out all the hair and debris and anything else that got into it. These filters are really good. They do a really good job. And they're a lot better than a coffee filter. I got my new second jar. People ask why I only milk once a day. The previous owners only milked once a day, and it just makes things a little bit easier so you don't have to do this twice a day. And she gives enough milk once a day that we don't need to do it twice a day. So, I mean, this works for us. Now we're gonna put these in the freezer for an hour and a half, and might take this one out a little bit less time because I don't want it to freeze. I'm just gonna set our timer, and that's it. And then we have delicious milk, and I'll show you what we make with it. Here we have our second attempts at goat milk ice cream, and it's not bad. We're still working on this formula to get it right, but it tastes pretty good. I just need to figure out how to get creamier. More eggs, I think. And I think today we're going to try our hand at some goat milk yogurt. For right now, I'm going to show you why we do this. Cheers. It's so sweet and good. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you in the next video. We ran to the store today to get medicine to sedate our noisy goat. Actually, we got some homeopathy. I gotta do a video on homeopathy at some point, kind of explain to you guys what it is and why we use it. But what I ended up getting was lachesis, arsenicum, and this is Sedalia. These are individual remedies. I do think the lachesis fits our goat
perfectly because she is a little bit jealous and needy and has separation anxiety. The arsenicum is another one that also helps with separation anxiety. And then if neither one of these works, then we'll try the sedalia, which is kind of like six different types of homeopathy in one. We'll just give it to her one at a time and see which one works, and if none of them work, then we'll just dose ourselves. While I was picking these up, though, I went to the post office and we had a nice surprise from Ireland.
Yep, this letter is from Christy at the Swallow Inn in Araglen, Killeworth, Ireland. So, really sweet letter. We love all the mail you guys send. Keep on sending it. We keep everything, and we have a little box that we put it in.
Yeah, we went to write Christy back. She left us an email address, but for some reason the email's not working, so we just wanted to give her a shout-out here. Thanks so much for reaching out to us. We appreciate it, guys. See you in the next video.